Hello everyone, my name is Usman Ahmed and I work in Grafana Labs as a Senior Developer Advocate. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to install Grafana using Helm chart. It will be a complete step-by-step introduction so that you can install, configure and deploy it easily on Kubernetes. So let's get started. So we have a complete Helm chart documentation and you can find it easily by going to grafana.com and click go to the docs and here you will click on Grafana. On the left side, you will find the link setup. So if you click it, it should give you the option to install Grafana, expand it, and there you will find the link Grafana on Helm charts. A quick introduction about Helm. Helm is basically an open source tool which helps you to deploy applications on Kubernetes easily. The traditional way is to deploy via YAML files, but you can automate it or make it easier by using this Helm chart templates. And we will now take a look into it. Before you begin, please make sure that you have a Kubernetes cluster up and running on your machine. And also you need to download the Helm tool itself. You can find the link here, which will take you to the official page. So let's get started. The first thing we will do is that we will create a Grafana repo. And by doing that, we need to first add the repo in our Kubernetes cluster. So the very first thing, we will add the Grafana repository. So this is important so that we can download the Grafana packages in our Kubernetes cluster. So what I will do is that copy this command and I'm already on my terminal and I will just paste it. And now Grafana repo is added and you can verify it by using helm repo list command and it will give you the information that yes, Grafana repo is there. You will also need to update it. So helm repo update. And now our repository is up to date and ready for installation. Now the next thing we will gonna do is to create a Kubernetes namespace. What it will do, it will create a separate area for our Grafana Helm chart so that if we are using the default namespace, maybe there might be a conflict with ports or settings. So using a different namespace will give us isolation and still we can do our deployment easily. So in order to create a namespace, you will just copy this command, kubectl create namespace, and I'm giving this name as monitoring. So like that. And now the namespace is created. The next step will be is to search for the Grafana repo. So you can search for Grafana repo using this command, which will give you a list of Grafana repository. So we are interested in installing the Grafana repo. And in order to do that, we will use the helm install command. And we are telling basically that helm install my Grafana. This is our logical name, right? And Grafana is the repository and the namespace is monitoring. So we'll just paste it here. And now Grafana is available on our Kubernetes cluster. It also gives us some information. For example, the name is my Grafana. This is the name we give to our deployment. This is the last deployed timestamp, the namespace, and so on. What important here is that we need to get the Grafana admin password. And to do that, we have to run this command. So basically, just copy this whole command, copy it, and then paste it. And this will give you the password. So for now, I will just copy it and I will just save in a Word file. The next step is to access the Grafana server. And to do that, we have to run this command. This is all instructions given by the Helm chart itself, so it's not something different, and you will also get it. So you just copy it, and now run the second command. What this command is telling us is that we are telling that that using the kubectl to port forward the Grafana pod on the port 3000. And what it will do that it will start port forwarding. So if I go on my browser, I will be able to log into Grafana. Now, in order to log in, you can type the admin as the user, but for the password, you need to copy paste the password which was provided in the instructions. So you just copy it and paste here. And now we are logged into our Grafana server. Now Grafana is up and running, but there are a few things which we need to make sure before we can say that Grafana is running correctly. And we need to customize its configuration. And to do that, we have to use the values.yaml file. Basically, when you install Grafana or any other application using Helm charts and use the Helm command, it is a bundle of package which contains the default configuration. And in order to modify this default configuration, you have to use the values.yaml file. The values.yaml file basically contains all the configuration details of a particular application, in our case, such as Grafana. And you can read more about values.yaml file from the Helm official link using this one. And in our case, we need to download the values.yaml file. So I have already downloaded this file. And let me show you. So this is how a values.yaml file looks like. So basically, it's a collection of all the Grafana configuration, and we can modify it. So the first thing which we need to make sure is to enable the persistent storage. So right now, the PVC is not enabled. So what it means that if we try to create a dashboard or configure a data source, it will not be safe because there is a no volume defined. And let me show you what it means that if I go in this file and I search for persistence, so you can see that the type is PVC, but it is not enabled by default. It is set to false and we need to enable it. So what I will do is that I will set it to true. And now, after that, we need to run the helm upgrade command. So helm upgrade my Grafana, the repo name, then pointing to the file -f values.yaml, and then to the namespace monitoring. And even just before that, we can also verify that PVC does not exist. So how you can do that? So kubectl get PVC -n monitor. So currently it says no resource found in monitoring namespace. Now, if we run this command, because we have already the file values.yaml configured and set it to true for PVC, it will take a moment. And now it says that it is deployed. But what we are interested is to see that if the PVC is now available. So if we run the same PVC command using kubectl, now we will see that it is the name of our deployment, my Grafana. Status is right now pending, but we will see shortly that it is populated. And now that means we can save our dashboard and data sources and other data whatever we create in Grafana. So now if we take a look again, now the volume is populated, that it has a volume PVC with a number. The capacity is 10 GB and with read write one as the access mode. And you can do same for plugins if you want to install. You can go to the plugin section in the values.yaml file. And for example, if you want to install Grafana Clock Panel or Zavix plugin, you can do that here as well. For the troubleshooting, it is important to get the logs if you run into issues. And to do that, you can simply run this command. So what it will do is that, let me clear my screen. If I run this command, I will get the complete log files of my Grafana deployment. And this can be useful if need for troubleshooting or creating an issue for a bug or a problem. Similarly, you can increase the log level. So the default level of Grafana is the info mode, but maybe you need to enable to debug mode. And to do that, you can simply again edit the values.yaml file. So let's find the instructions. So we will first clear the screen and go to the values.yaml file. and we will search for the string Grafana.ini. Okay, so here we find the Grafana.ini, and then we will go to the log mode console, and here we can add the path as level is equals to debug, and then save our configuration. And now if we want to apply this configuration, we will again use the help upgrade command, copy it, paste it here. And now if we try to look our log file using the kubectl log command, we will see the log leveled in debug mode. So let me show you. Yeah, so the level is debug mode now, and it shows more detailed logs, and this is helpful if you want to troubleshoot issues. So that's all. Thank you very much. I hope you learn a lot from this session, and see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.